Federal and state officials met in Ohio today to deal with a pesky plague that's been spreading all summer, all across the country. Bed bugs are back and forcing government officials and homeowners to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars to kill the pests. Here's Lindsay Davis.
Overnight, bed bugs have become so much of a concern, several states are calling on the big guns for help. At least five states are pleading for money to get rid of these pesky bloodsuckers. Representatives and experts from a long list of government agencies, including the Department of Defense, met in Columbus, Ohio today to talk bed bugs.
Hopefully we're going to see more resources devoted to various things, such as the educational things, resources perhaps to help people who can't pay for treatment.
Ohio was so desperate, they petitioned the government to allow in-home use of a pesticide banned out of concern for its effects on kids. That request was denied.
This is a resurgence all across the board at this point, so it's a very serious problem.
In Lexington, Kentucky, bed bugs force people out of their apartments. In Fort Worth, Texas, the city housing authority spent $500,000 to rid this apartment building of the pests. It didn't work. In Seattle, bed bug calls to exterminators have spiked.
Contrary to their name, bed bugs aren't limited to beds. This Times Square movie theater is back open after shutting its doors Tuesday night to deal with the paranoia and panic-inducing parasite.
Bed bugs tend to be nocturnal. They like to hide in cracks and crevices, often in and around mattresses. They're visible to the eye. They bite humans, and it's painful. The retro pests were eradicated from the U.S. around the end of World War II, but in the last decade, they've been making a comeback.
It has to do with the pesticides we use today not being as effective as they once were, say, in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. The immunity makes them more difficult to treat.
A painful pest that has many people this summer on edge. Lindsay Davis, ABC News, New York.